In Jackson, section 1.11, he considered a system with two point charges and calculate the electrostatic potential energy by integrating the energy density from the electric field. Okay, so first you write down the electric field of the two point charges. So E as a function X, you have two charges. So each one has a factor 4 pi epsilon 0. So you have Q1 and X minus X1 divided by X minus X1 cubed plus Q2 X minus X2 divided by X minus X2 cubed. Okay, so you use the definition of the electric field density, energy density. So you have epsilon 0 over 2 E square, the vector square. So that will give you, so there will be three terms. So one is, so you have 1632 pi squared and epsilon 0. So the first one would be Q1 squared X, actually just X minus X1 squared a fourth plus Q2 squared X minus X2 four plus Q1 Q2 X minus X1 dot X minus X2, actually two of them, divided by X minus X1 cube, X minus X2 cube. Okay, so this is the energy density. Now, if you want the total energy, you can supposedly integrate that over all space. This is defined from infinite space. Okay, but of course, we look at the form of W. So you put it in the integral, integrating over all space, you notice that the first two terms, because of this X minus X1 to the fourth power, this X minus X2 to the fourth power. So we'll do the integration, the volume integration near the point, either one or two will diverge because the volume only proportional X minus X1 cubed, but this is divided by X minus X1 fourth. So the integration will diverge. So, and the second term also. So the first two terms actually doesn't make sense. Actually, when you look back the derivation of the field energy density, actually we start with, when we start with point charge, we don't consider the self energy. Okay, so this is only after we introduce a smooth charge density, we get the electric field and the field energy density of this form. Okay, but go back to discrete charge, we should get rid of this self, these two terms. Okay, so we only need to consider the interaction potential energy is given by just integrating the third term. Now, take out the constant Q1, Q2, 32, actually 16, because you have to multiply by 2, 16 pi square epsilon 0, integrating over the whole space, X minus X1 dot into X minus X2, integrate over whole space, divided by X minus X1 cube, X minus X2 cube. Okay, and now this integration seems complicated and doesn't look like we'll go back to what we start with, which is 1 over x1 minus x, the distance x1 minus x2. But actually, there's it's actually quite easy to show that. Okay, so Jackson actually presented another way to integrate it directly, which is looks more complicated than it actually is, and he didn't have too much detail. So I'll fill in some of the detail here. Just consider this in this integram. So just do this integration by Jackson's method by a change of variable. So the changing of the variable is changed from integrating over x to integrating over a space q. So this q at row is defined as this x minus x1 and normalize if this the distance x1 minus x2. Okay, so you just choose one of them to define as rho. I mean, you can choose the other one, it doesn't matter. So this means that now you can write x minus x1. Whenever you see x minus x1, this becomes this x1 minus x2 distance times rho. Okay, and then x minus x2 can be changed to say x minus x1 minus or plus x1 minus x2. Okay, and the first two terms are just using the first equation, so x1 minus x2 times rho, and the second one is just the second x1 minus x2 vector is just the x1 minus vector distance times the unit vector, which we'll define as n. So x1 minus x2 times n. Okay, so so that is x1 minus x2. So now you can put the dot product x minus x1 dot into x minus x2, just this one dot into here. So both terms has x1 minus x2 distance. So you get two of them. And then you have rho dot into rho. Okay, so so you have rho dot into rho. So you have rho square plus rho dot into n. So that is the dot product. Okay. Okay. So now we can put everything into this double interaction. So you have Q1, Q2, 16 pi squared epsilon zero. So substitute everything. So this one, this one goes to here. So you have two of these x1 minus x2 factor here. And this two, take the absolute value, will go into here. So both will have x1 minus x2, x1 minus x2 values over there. So so all together, you have, let's just write it down. So the first one is this one square. And actually we need one more thing because we are doing a change variable. So changing from x to q. So, and q, this is normalized with this. So this one more thing is this dqx it's just x1 minus x2 dq of q of rho, actually. dq of rho. Not this one. Okay, so actually three of them. So now you have in the numerator, you have this, either one of them has two, this distance factor, and this dqx has three, and the denominator has six of them. So all together you have one x1 minus x2 distance. You can take that out of the integration because it doesn't depend on rho. Okay, so finally you have a, let's actually, in the integral we can write q rho dot rho plus n, and in the numerator one is rho q, the other is rho plus n the distance q and dq rho dq, yeah, dq rho. Okay, and now what we'll use is that the fact that we actually learned before, this rho plus n divided by rho plus n distance cube. This is just minus a gradient of rho, 1 over rho plus n. Okay, so we, let's just consider this integration. So with the carrying the factor in front, so this equals to integrating rho dot, actually minus rho dot gradient rho, 1 over rho plus n dq rho, okay, and divided by the this rho q factor. Okay, now we'll do an integration by parts, something like an integration by parts. This is this will be divergence of, so take the divergence of everything. Divergence of this rho over rho q factor divided by the distance rho plus n. Okay, this is the, put everything in the divergence, so you need to subtract the other terms, so you subtract the, yeah, the first term you have is this vector dot in the gradient of this one, so you subtract the divergence of this vector divided by this scalar, so divergence of. One over rho plus n distance and divergence of this rho over rho cube. dq rho. Okay. Now the first term is a total divergence, so we can use the divergence theorem. And we're integrating over the full space. So the first term will be just an integration in rho goes to infinity. And the this vector dot A or dA outside. So you have rho Q, rho plus N. Okay. And this integration or surface integral over the infinite distance, so totally the denominator has rho Q, you cancel one rho first, it's rho square times rho, you have three rho Q factor in the denominator, the area proportional to rho square. So the total integral, total is depends on one over of rho, so all together that would be goes to zero. So the can keep the negative sign. So that term goes to zero. Okay, so now the second term is so you have let's see. This is a negative rho. And seems like I'm getting a sign wrong. So let's see. This is oh no, the sign is okay. Yeah, because I'm taking a divergence of this one. And so you have positive sign and positive sign. So the next term is this. Second term is divergence of this one. And we see that this is a negative gradient, one over rho, and Laplacian one over gradient is negative 4 pi. Delta function, so all together this is 4 pi delta rho vector q rho, and then you have rho plus n distance here. Okay, and after you do the evaluation of the delta function, so this becomes just 4 pi over the magnitude n, which is this is a unit vector, so it's 1, so it's 4 pi. Okay, so altogether, this integral give you 4 pi. Okay, so this W interaction is just Q1, Q2, cancel 4 pi, give you 4 pi epsilon 0, x1 minus x2. Okay, so that is some evaluation of the integral of this all this vector identity and integration by parts, and you get back the what the electric potential supposed to be, because that's what we start with. So we have a potential of Q, like the potential produced by Q1 and then Q2 go into X2 at the potential, so you evaluate the potential x2, so you have x1 minus x2 distance, and so that would be the energy q1 q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon and the distance between the two charges. Okay, so and so after some integration you get back to the same result. All right, so that's all for this discussion.